All right, let's find the area of a triangle where we are given three side lengths, but we don't know how high this triangle is, the altitude going from, this was set flat, the top, all the way to the bottom. So we can't really use that 1/2 base times height, like maybe you've used in the past for finding the area of triangles. Instead, let's use Heron's formula. So to do this, what we want to do is, this is the formula for our area, but first we need to calculate what we refer to as the semi-perimeter. In getting going on this, I'm going to label my smallest side as A, my medium side length as B, and my largest side length as C. So the semi-perimeter, S, is going to be calculated by doing A plus B plus C, all divided by 2. So it's not the average, it's the semi-perimeter as we get going on this. So adding the numerators together, we get 75 divided by 2. In my situation, works out to be 37.5. All right, next up, let's go ahead and fill into that area formula. So it's going to be the square root of S, 37.5, multiplied by 37.5 minus A, which is 19, multiplied by 37.5 minus B, in my case, 24, and 37.5 minus C, which is 32. All right, let's do just a little bit of reducing down before we punch it into the calculator. Make sure we're all on the same page. So 37.5 minus 19 is going to be 18.5. Minus 24 is going to be 13.5. And minus 32 is going to be 5.5. Just reducing those down first. And then we'll put this into the calculator. I got my area to equal. The square root of all of these multiplied together was 226.96. And as far as our units go on this, because our side lengths were in centimeters, this is going to be in centimeters squared. All right, hope this helps out as you're setting up Heron's formula. Calculate that semi-perimeter first and then fill in strategically on each one of these. I just chose A to be the smallest, B the next, and C the largest side length. All right, hope this helps out. Good luck on it.